A transmissible RNA pathway in honeybees. So what? How that's gonna help my bees? If there is something that I'm gonna emphasize in this channel over and over, is the fact that bee biology is the key to be a successful beekeeper. Welcome to InsideTheHive.tv, the show that takes you into the world of bees. Dr. Eyal Maori and collaborators in Cambridge University a week ago just released a scientific article that I believe have the potential to make us beekeepers more successful in the near future. As you probably know, RNAs are very important molecules. They can play active roles within the cells, catalyzing enzymatic reactions, controlling gene expression, signaling, and much more other functions. We also know that RNAs can be transmitted from one cell to another. However, what we didn't know is that, at least in honeybees, RNAs can be transmitted from one individual to another, preserving their biological properties. And the reasons for that is the beauty of this story. As a short background, researchers in the past using double-stranded RNA in the feeding of bees were able to demonstrate the efficiency of the RNA consumption to fight a honeybee virus infection. The virus in this case was IAPV. In that experiment, the researchers were able to show that the levels of the virus went down, the honey production was up, and many other different beneficial effects. What was unexpected for these researchers, and they couldn't understand why that happened, was that after 4 months, the beneficial effect is still in the colonies that were treated with the RNA. However, we know that in 4 months, a honeybee colony replaced his whole population. So how a honeybee that never entered in contact with the RNA before was able to preserve the beneficial effect of the treatment? And the explanation for this phenomena is what is this new article is all about. The main message in this new article is that honeybees are able to collect environmental RNA, process them in the digestive system, spread them systemically through the hemolymph using a protein RNA complex that's gonna end up being secreted in the jelly, royal jelly and worker jelly of bees by the nursery bees. But the question is, why? Why bees are transferring a whole set of different RNAs to the future generations? The results suggested that this might be a system in honeybees to faster adaptation in the environment they are in. Dr. Maori found a full range of RNAs in the royal jelly and worker jellies of bees. Viruses RNA, bacteria RNA, plant RNA, fungi RNA, regulatory RNAs, RNAs that we don't even know what the function is about. So the idea here is that bees might be able to learn what needs to be done metabolically in the environment they are in and transfer this set of RNA or this new information about that environment to the future bees for faster adaptation. If you're a beekeeper like my dad, you're probably asking yourself, so what? How that's gonna help my bees? If these experiments are confirmed, we might be able in the near future to create specific diet with a specific set of RNA for different environments. And that's very exciting. For example, you know for a fact that in a bee yard, you always have bees, honeybees colonies that perform much better than others. That would be the case that the bees that perform better already have the set of RNAs that they need for that specific environment. Can we feed the weaker colonies with some part of the jelly, the royal jelly and worker jelly from the stronger colony to the weaker, and they might recover and perform better in that environment? That's a possibility. Another possibility is, over winter, can we create a jelly, a food that have the specific set of RNA for that environment to perform better in that winter? So avoiding losses and saving bees and saving money. All of these ideas are possibilities that if these experiments are correct, you're gonna be able to create a lot of different tools. If you're a commercial beekeeper, for example, and you need to travel your bees all around, how cool would it be if you know in advance that what kind of set of RNAs you need to put in their diet to perform the best in a blueberry crop situation or in an almond situation or wherever place you're gonna put your bees, if you know in advance what kind of set of RNAs you need to put in the food for them to perform better, that's a huge, huge advantage. Now I would like to hear from you. What would you do in your beekeeping operation with this kind of information? What kind of ideas can we bring to the table to create different kind of tools for using this knowledge? I would like to hear your comments. Please leave your comments in the comment below, and I would love to brainstorm with you guys. Now, just between us, a little secret. I'm already performing some of those experiments, so if you want to follow this up, please consider to subscribe. I encourage everyone to read this article. Even if you're not a scientist and don't understand the technical terms, that's what I'm here for. I would love to answer all your questions and try to address all of your concerns. And if I don't know the answer, I know a guy that might know the answer. Dr. Eyal Maori is a good collaborator of mine, and I'm sure he's gonna be happy to answer questions for you guys too. If you like this video, show me some love, hit the like button below, consider to subscribe, share with friends and family, and that's it for now. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.